I see you all in a long sit with your shoulders down nicely and heads up so you're feeling very comfortable. That was a lovely playtime. You've come in very calmly. Well done, everybody. While you're going through these exercises, I want you to remember what we've been learning about symmetry this week and to be thinking about which of those positions that we do in yoga, Sammy, are symmetrical and which are not symmetrical. Think about your own line of symmetry before we start. Put your hand in the middle of your head here and just go down the middle of your nose to your lips and to your chin and stop. Remember, that goes right down through your tummy button, right down to your toes. You ready? Very good. Well done. Bridge. Arrow. Cobra. Very good. Lovely arched backs there. Excellent. We're going to think about what kind of symmetrical pattern we can make with our bodies where they're lying now. So the first thing you need is your hands on your tummy. I want you to put your right hand, and that is the hand that's nearest to this window, at right angles to your body. When we're talking about right angles, we're talking about a square corner, aren't we? Is that a square corner there, do you think? Can you make it any squarer than that?
Okay.
How many degrees are there in a right angle?
90.
Well done. Excellent. Now see if you can make your hand at right angles to the rest of your arm. So it's going to bend like this.
Oh, Jesus.
Any way you like. Now make your other arm match it. Does it match completely? That's very good indeed. Well done.
This.
All right, well done. Now put your legs in a symmetrical position. I don't mind what it is. You need to be able to stay still with it. Good. And relax, go back into supine, please. You ready? Now, what I want you to do now is to arrange those things in this pattern so that if you're standing here, it's symmetrical, and if you're standing over here, it's symmetrical. Do you think you can do that?
Yeah.
Give it a whirl. Go on, go for it. When you've put down the four things that you had, if you want to go and find some more bigger things, you can do that. Where are you going to put them, Chris? Oh, that's clever. Right, when you've done that, will you come and sit down? Sammy. Don't sit... Oh, right, then. Go on, then. Go on, then.
That's why I did it. That's why
go on,
I did
then.
It.
Those won't work because they've got a pattern on them. Now, let's have a look at this and see whether it's right. Shall we have a look at Chelsea's stool and Jason's stool? Shall we have a look at Chelsea's stool and Jason's stool? Is that all right?
No.
Tell me what's wrong then. Hold on
Chelsea
a sec.
Chelsea's chairs needs to come back.
It does.
And that needs to keep going back, Chelsea. But there. And then you move that chair
back. All the other chairs
no,
are
that,
right there.
That one was. That one's fine. Good. Well done, Sammy. Our aim in this lesson was to be able to, as it says up here, recognise lines of symmetry. You've made things to show us that you can recognise where lines of symmetry are. Now, this is our last thing. Wait a minute. I want you to look at this pattern on this rug. And with these pipe cleaners, do not bend them, or I shall be mad as a wet hen. I want you to put your pipe cleaners where you think the lines of symmetry are. Go for it.
Yeah, okay.
What do you think? Yes, put it in the middle, and then let's have a look at it together, shall we? Because children learn in such very different ways and some will find some things much easier than others, that seems to really work very well. They work together as a team quite well, so we may find, for instance, that we can use a year five child explaining something to a year three, and that means that they're reinforcing what they learnt in the first place, and that works really well.